After 2 decades in marine science, I have learned the essential lesson that you can't underestimate the ocean. Every time I think I understand what's gonna happen,
this is really a rare observation.
Nature surprises me, and that is wonderful. It's been a month at sea, and in this month we have gone to 5 seamounts that have never before been seen or mapped and aren't owned by any country. These are high sea seamounts. And in each of these seamounts, what we've seen is a diversity of life, likely found a number of new species. We have observed new behaviors that we haven't seen before. Interactions between animals that some of which we were looking for and many of which just surprised us.
What? Fish?
Did you see the fish?
Awesome. Wait. He just caught a fish.
What?
And now he's eating it.
We've come out here without a map and made a map and dove in these areas and discovered new things. It's just been a tremendous experience.
Working in these remote marine protected areas where we've been operating is an ideal scenario. It's as close as we can get to a pristine ocean. One of the major accomplishments of this trip has been the first major study of coral livery, the consumption of live corals by predators on the seafloor. How do these corals respond to injury and potential infection? To answer these questions, we've taken these corals and conducted a series of novel experiments here on the ship, looking at how these corals can respond to different microbial challenges, to bacteria that are familiar, those that are unfamiliar, really trying to get at the origins of their immune systems and how they might respond. So I've been working in this part of the world for almost 15 years now. And usually when I'm out here, I'm working south of the equator in the Republic of Kiribati. And it's really important to me to always have somebody from this part of the world with us as a member of the team.
I'm from the beautiful island nation of Kiribati. We are known as voyages. That is our history and our heritage. The ocean is important to my culture because we're deeply connected to it. As a student of marine biology at the Brigham Young University of Hawaii, I have found that this experience on ship has been very valuable. I have learned so much from the scientists about deep sea animals. This knowledge helps me to become a great scientist.
So the main thing that I was doing out here is conducting research on associates of corals. Associates are those animals that live on corals and they partner up with them, sometimes for life. And so it's that association that I want to understand. What really amazes me is the animals that live on those corals. Coral provides the habitat framework for these animals, and it's not just one or two species. We're talking about hundreds of species that live on these corals. And what's so amazing to me is how specific they are to these corals. A certain coral species will only have one type of associate animal living on it. It's simply amazing these partnerships that are developed, that have co-evolved over thousands or not millions of years to support that kind of diversity.
In a month, there are so many wonderful moments, surprising moments, great moments, funny moments. And I think the funny moments are my favorite. The moments where, for example, where here we are transiting up to the mesophotic and I'm trying to look at a coral that I can't quite identify yet. And then all of a sudden, there are moray eels that are just demanding our attention, or we're trying to look at a coral over here. And the humor that that brings to the control room, I mean, I'm still laughing about it weeks later. And I just think it's great to sort of have those moments on the seafloor.
In one case, we saw this massive wall of corals. It was fantastic. I've never seen anything like it, really. And it was loaded with animals living on them, the crabs and the shrimp and things that I study. We came up and over that wall after studying it for hours and came onto a field, a complete field of the same species, just anywhere an expanse. But it was unexpected. And it gave me pause to think about what really controls that. Is it the currents, the nutrients? Do they all settle together for some reason? It raised more questions than it gave us answers.
One of the most important things that I've learned is collaboration. To work together with different people from different backgrounds has been satisfying and fun.